All right, check it out, guys. I got my 2005 or 6 Ford Escape. I hooked up my fuel pressure gauge right after the fuel filter to a T fitting that came with the kit. So anyways, I can keep it running. Check the pressure while it's running and make sure it holds pressure. Now I just bought an aftermarket fuel pump on eBay. So right now it's at pretty close to zero. I can release it just so we can get an absolute zero reading. All right, should be zero-ish. That button's pretty stiff. Sorry for the video. There we go. All right, now I'm gonna prime it once. Jumps up to about 50. Let me do it one more time. All right, 60. And let's see how long it holds. They say it should hold above 30 for 5 minutes. I'm not gonna sit here for 5 minutes, but it's about 48 right now. I'm gonna say that's all good. I'm gonna go ahead and start it. The problem I've been having is it starts and shuts off right away. Look at that fuel pressure just drop while it's running. 15 PSI, 14, 10 PSI. There goes, engine starting to shake. There you go, jump back. Right. I mean, is this what you get when you buy an aftermarket fuel pump? Oh boy. All right, well, there's certain idle fuel pressure specs while it's running. You got a second, I'll go check that. Use my shot, it's a mess. Anyways, pop up the good old computer here. Hey guys, you can see me. All right. Okay, just regular old all data program here. Just gonna get some specs. Here's a Ford Escape 2005, it is 05. Okay, so we're gonna just jump right to fuel pressure. All right, fuel pressure, specs. Key on, engine off, 39 PSI. Engine running, 39 PSI. So I'm not okay with that 15 PSI. So what I'm gonna do is contact the vendor and probably get a name brand fuel pump. Call it a day. Okay, thanks, bye.